Hey everyone, Daniel Vadnell for Fitness FAQs. This video we will cover key cues to properly perform the hanging knee raise or the hanging leg raise, and just as importantly, the common mistakes that people make when they're training their abs with this movement. To start with, an absolutely fantastic exercise to use as a warm-up prior to your core training is this prep drill. I want you to get into a hollow body position. From here, keeping the lower back flat against the ground, I want you to maximally flex at the hip in a controlled fashion. Your full range of motion is when the lower back begins to rise off the ground. This is basically your body's way of compensating for missing hip flexion range. This is a good test because it'll show you what maximum height you can reach when you're doing your core work. If you try and force your body any higher than this, it's going to compensate through changes that we're going to discuss soon. I want you to keep these key points in mind when you're doing your hanging knee or leg raises. Most importantly is a vertical back position with an elevated chest. You're staying very vertical with absolutely no backwards lean at all during the movement. From here, keep your elbows completely locked straight. Control the tempo on both the way up and the way down to maximally recruit the abs. And a pro tip that you can keep in mind when you're doing the movement is to have your legs slightly forward of the hips to minimize not only the swing, but also to keep your pelvis in a good position and maintain tension. If you do the exercise in the way that I've described, you're preferentially going to target both your hip flexors and abs without any compromise elsewhere. If you want to force yourself to be in a good position, I encourage you to do this movement in a chin-up grip. This position makes it a lot more challenging to lean backwards, so it ultimately forces your abs to do more of the work. The ideal way to do this exercise is using stall bars, but basically with some creativity you can find alternate ways to achieve the same effect. As you can see here, I'm using my pull-up bar post and I'm just fixing my back against the post. No compromise, no cheat, nice vertical posture, and it really forces me to use my hip flexors and my abs. I know that most of you watching this would have a doorway chin-up bar, and that's the perfect way to do your knee or leg raises. Very simple, close the door, keep your back flat against the door, and then rise until you feel like your lower back is about to lose contact with the wall. I can guarantee that you're going to instantly feel the difference when you do them with your back supported versus unsupported. You'll be really surprised at all the little cheats that your body makes to do the exercise easier. If you're training with a friend, get them involved in the action. Get them to help make the exercise harder. Ask them to apply a decent amount of pressure to your mid-back, and this is going to force you not to lean backwards, really working the anterior abs. Now I want to talk about the most common mistakes that I see people make time and time again with their core training. Falling into an anterior pelvic tilt. This happens by losing tension at the bottom and relaxing and disengaging the abdominals. We don't want to do this because it reinforces a pattern which is unhelpful for the bodyweight athlete. To avoid this, keep tight and have the legs in front of the body to maintain more of a neutral to posteriorly tilted pelvis, keeping that tight engagement. The next is a classic. If you train at a commercial gym, you've probably seen this one, swinging and using momentum. Like on most exercises, when people lack strength, they cheat and use momentum. This is most common on the way up with a rapid swing to initiate the movement and get yourself through range. By doing it in this way, sure, you can do a large number of reps, but we would rather see less reps done correctly for the best results. Another cheat is bending the arms. This demonstrates a lack of scapular stability and overall shoulder girdle strength. Drop down to the hanging knee raise if you must, but make sure that the elbows are straight at all times. This is the biggest takeaway from the video. Do not lean backwards. Leaning backwards recruits the back and the lats to a really large extent. This is particularly common when people lack mobility and then they force themselves to try and reach their toes to the bar. As you can see from me doing it, it's mainly training the back and really recruiting the lats and shoulder extension instead of focusing on what we're trying to do. Remember, we are trying to train the anterior core and the hip flexors, so stay vertical and don't lean backwards. Thank you guys so much for watching. Visit fitnessfaqs.tv to master your body with training programs, coaching, blogs, and much, much more.